So today's lecture, it's really good. I don't know that we ever intended it to be this way.
The chapter will help, but you don't have to read the damn thing. You just have to buy the book.
So constitutive induced. And as I am, very repressed.
So remember, brain is involved here. Everything that has an eye has a brain. In fact, the eye is directly connected to the brain. So perceiving color is all about the brain. Don't lose sight of that.
Realize I said that. Don't lose sight of that.
We're gonna close up with something. So if you're a bacterial taxonomist, you know, your whole life is spent looking at bacteria. In fact, you just love bacteria. You just don't love anything else. You just love bacteria. One of the defining characteristics of E. coli is that it can't grow on citrate. You know, like you're an old crusty fart that smokes a pipe, like I will in a few years. How does she know they share a common ancestor? Like, no one raised their hand and said, how in the hell do you know that, Beth? Like, how do you know that they diverged from a common ancestor? What? Because these kind of bones look the same? Like, what a bunch of crap. Like, that's nonsense. They do have. They've gained this ability to use citrate as a carbon source. By magic. Evolution's all magic. I think I'd get fired if I really did that. Okay.
Last year, I walked into her lecture and said, all right, Kay, give it to me. How do you define entropy? And she goes, well, Dennis, it's a measure of disorder. And I say, well, what do you mean, disorder? Well, it's just that, it's disorder. So disorder's hard to define. It's hard to measure. It's not a great analogy for entropy. In fact, it's pretty shitty. I need you guys to interact with me more. I think next week I'm gonna start bringing Twinkies to class, my favorite snack food. And then maybe that will entice people. Okay, so every time you make a fried egg, I want you to think of me. You might think of me doing other things, but when you make a fried egg, you think of me.
Suada salsa.
Shake, shake, shake. Shake, shake, shake.
I like shakes, chocolate shakes, I like them.
So if your girlfriend says, you're the food that keeps me alive, she's lying. Tell her that in a nice way, but I think it's an important thing you have to talk about.
It doesn't really make sense to attempt a global alignment in many situations. Don't write that down, just say, I don't know, say, I'm hungry. Okay. Thiomargarita is gigantic. What are these cells doing that enable them to be so much bigger than E. coli? These things are massive.
Here's a molecule of glucose, and when it ferments, I get ethanol out, the backbone of the Canadian economy.
You don't have to guess. You just sequence the genome for a couple thousand dollars. Dollars, I sound like I'm Canadian. Okay, so far we've made some ATP. We've made NADH, and we've made FADH2. But think of FADH2 as the Spanish peso and NADH as the French franc. We don't want those, man. We want euros. We want ATP.
And for just adding urea and taking urea away, I mean, that experiment must have cost them like $1.50.
That's okay. Come on. It's understandable you'd be drunk on the last day of class. I'm gonna fucking... So just so no one's confused, this is, remember we had those tubes and some turned purple. We've got equal amounts of enzyme. Okay? So we'll just take a little, rewind a little, refresh ourselves. How big is my beak? That sounded kind of strange. Right, so... So exciting. Things like intron, who cares if there's a mutation in intron? Fibrinopeptides are clotting factors. They're proteins which plug a hole when somebody stabs you in your chest. So fibrinopeptides, I mean, frig, any protein could do that job. So what the hell, like, you can change, mutate the hell out of that protein. It still can clog the knife wound.
And send me your pictures. I want to see photographs of you guys doing weird things with dental floss. Not too weird, just like, all right?
Let's trim this, man. This baby's gotta be trim, because it takes too much energy to maintain. Get rid of all this junk.
I don't like when students take advantage of me. I don't know what I meant to say.
So come with your results from your own blast work. You can do it in Paris, do it naked in the bathtub, I don't care.
Something weird happened. At the optimum than it is on either side.
So
What processes? The processes? The processes? Processes?
We don't want any of the sex involved here. It just complicates everything in life. Okay, we won't talk about that. Okay, interesting so far. Someone in the back yawned. I'll ignore that.
There's nothing you can really do to prepare for that kind of question. Just come to the test prepared. Just think, sleep, eat, all of that, exercise.
Correct. The average was 66%, which is very good, considering how hard the test was.
Next year, if any of you are still around. And so if you really want to talk about convergent evolution, you've got to talk about cows. The joke is, you'd think we're at the University of Guelph if we show a picture of a cow. Then you call up your friend who's a cow expert and say, how long has it been since humans and cows diverged? Well, a little over 100 million years ago. All right, cool, thanks for that. And you hang up the phone.
If you're stressed, just get your mom to lick you.
Geography going on here.
You skipped over my monkey.
Oh, okay, yeah, that's right. There's Tom's monkey. Oh, that's
right. Isn't that the best monkey?
Haven't you always wanted a monkey? It's like the IKEA monkey.
And how we're going to do that and so on was what I was going to talk about for 20 minutes today. And we're going to do that. We're going to do that in the next class. So.
Yeah, because, okay, last point.
No, I had the last point.
No, Frank, you need to have enough DNA so you can manipulate it. You can actually cut this out of the gel.
If you have something to contribute to this effort, I would appreciate it if you have an experience that you would share with me, a positive one about Dennis's teaching. That would be great. I can use that. Just send it to me directly by email. We want you here to chat with and to make colonies and to be our boyfriends and girlfriends. That's going to be important. And I'm going to get a bell here. We're going to ring a bell whenever we do something that's really important. So ding! UTR.
Ding.
You can be the dinger. Star codons signal the start of translation.
Ding. Ding.
Because there are lots of genes that code for RNA, not for protein. Ding. The promoter region is a sequence of DNA. Ding. So, how many new partners have you had since classes started in September? Yourself doesn't count. And as I was mentioning, I was inspired to do this little talk because I'm standing in the gym in the change room after playing squash, and I overhear these two guys bragging about how many women they've slept with since the beginning of term and how close they are to their goal, and I think, you bastards are cancer factories. Like, this, all the men in this room, think of another way. The DNA that's in all of the men in this room wants to get into the next generation. These DNA binding proteins have particular structures that allow them to associate intimately with the DNA. Notice on this figure that there's a wide groove called the major groove and the minor groove of the double helix. So on the wings, so here on the right wing, I'd like you to blow off the lac promoter. Well, just pull it off. I understand that several of you have trouble with that. I don't know what that's about. It's worked fine last year, but I guess upgrades and so on have caused some issues. It's just a toy. It's not something that you have to do. But if you can run this simulation, or if you have a good friend you can sit down with, it'll be good. To bend the DNA. Just bends it, and that makes it more attractive. That makes the promoter more attractive. Okay, this one shows a circle. Which is great. It has a couple of other things, which is great. The tumor nucleus isn't a tumor nucleus. It's just a freaking nucleus. And you put it in a different environment with different transcription factors, it behaves perfectly fine. When you are walking into Loblaws and some little old lady has baked pink muffins to raise money for the cure, just tell her gently, there isn't one. No one's ever going to ask you name or research an enzyme unless you want to impress people. The parties that you know them, and the lac repressor is a classic example of a negative controlling element. And look what it does. Holy crap. Holy crap. For reasons I don't understand, the person who owned this cat wanted another one. So we go into nature to find those genes. We mine the biosphere. We just go into a high salt environment and scoop up everything. All the rats and the snakes and the slime and the bacteria and the viruses and the missing people. My mom really doesn't know much about biology formally, but if I asked her, I was 12 when we declared war on cancer. I'm 56. Yesterday was my birthday. This is a long time. So,
okay. This is a long Tom always says, don't leave the interesting stuff to last, but I do. This isn't interesting, but we have to do it anyway.
This class just before the midterm is often sort of sparsely
attended almost as sparsely as St. Patrick's Day always is, it seems. So I just want you to realize that science really just produces a whole bunch of arguments. They're not answers. It's just evidence and interpretation and arguments. And stuff that ends up in your textbook is really just a kind of consensus, kind of an agreement on what we think is going on. It's not really the answer in the sense that it could change. I think you realize that living from crisis to crisis, from chemistry to psych to calculus to bio, that's just no way to live. And I'm hopeful that as you move forward in your careers, you'll find ways. Those of you who are hearing my voice on the archive sometime next week, I hope you will find ways to have a more smooth academic life. The last time we were all here, we kind of weren't all together. We took our sort of trusting relationship in the class and drove it into the ditch. And this happens all the time in relationships with your family, your friends, your lovers, and sometimes it just gets weird. And I was chatting about what happened to the associate dean, and he said, "Well, I guess you'll never do that again." And that would be a choice. Whenever relationships go weird, we all have the choice just to walk away. But I think there's a better choice. We just get together and you talk. And you put it on the table and say, "Yeah, it went weird, and this is my part, and this is what I did, and I'm sorry about that." And then you expect the other person to do the same. "This is what I did, I'm sorry about that." And we commit to trying it again, and we give everybody a second chance, and we give it a go.
Nice, great. So that brings together material from the first term back into this term, and that wraps up this course. Have a very nice life.
Later!